Hey y'all, welcome back to my channel. So this is my grocery haul this week. Everything that you see behind me was $187 with tax. That is Walmart and that is Sam's Club. So let's get into the meal plan for the week. So here's the meal plan for March 25th through the 31st. The budget's always $150. However, I went over like $30-something this week. That's because we were out of a lot of condiments, keto condiments and things like that. So had to go ahead and stock up on some essentials for keto. And it gets a little pricey sometimes, but that's all right because we're doing better for ourselves. So for the menu, French toast with eggs and bacon by the Great Low Carb Bread Company. That's the cinnamon toast I got from them, guys. It is amazing as French toast. So definitely watch my vlog next week because I talk all about the cinnamon toast in general by itself and versus French toast. Amazing. And that will be coming to you guys for foodie this week. So if you're interested in the Great Low Carb Company bread products and you want to get that cinnamon toast to make that, you can go ahead and look at the link down below. It's like a bundle pack for a really good price. And I'm not sure if the cinnamon toast is included, but regardless, it'll take you to the website and you can get it. Amazing, guys. Highly, highly recommend. Like, I'm going to order that cinnamon toast from now on to make the French toast. It tasted like the real deal. I used my regular French toast recipe and I keto-fied it and then used that cinnamon toast and it was mind-blowing. So good. And I'm like still stuffed from it. Life isn't about finding yourself. Life is about creating yourself. Like, isn't that, that just spoke to me today for my keto journey. Like, you have to make things happen, guys. And as far as, you know, getting what you want, and if you want to do the keto lifestyle and you want to be successful at it, you have to create that yourself. Like, it's not just going to get handed to you. So I love that little quote for my meal planner today. And I'm losing stickers down in here, Lord. Cinnamon toast and coffee, I've already had a little bit of. Don't forget, I worked out today because I'm filming this on Monday. Yogurt, fruit, the Too Good yogurt, and coffee is an option for breakfast for me. Avocado, bacon, chicken salads are an option for lunch. I have some chicken I need to cook up and prep. Chicken quesadillas, I have those Mission low-carb tortillas I bought way back when. They're still good. We haven't tried them yet. They're 6 net carbs per tortilla, which is high for me, but I told y'all I'm trying to incorporate a little bit more carbs in my diet since I don't want to lose much more weight. So we are going to have chicken quesadillas keto style and I'm excited about it. Lily's chocolate is an option. I have a chocolate bar to eat a couple of pieces for sweets because I'm being lazy this week and not prepping a lot just because I was on that girl's beach vacation this past weekend and I'm just kind of like saying it's okay. It's all right. We can still make things happen. So I will like prep and do my normal like crazy stuff for keto next week, but Lily's chocolate will get me through and that's fine. Boiled eggs, bacon, or sausage for breakfast also is an option. Keto Lunchables, quick, easy, always have the ingredients on hand to make some type of keto Lunchables. So that is amazing. Leftovers, we're going to have chicken quesadillas again on Wednesday night. This sticker keeps coming off for love. Believe in yourself, and we're going to have my keto pizza on Thursday. I will link that in the iCards above. I have shared that on Foodie before with the Fathead Dough Pizza. It is amazing and so versatile. You can make that pizza any way you want on that Fathead dough. So that's it's, and you can use that Fathead dough for things other than pizza. I highly recommend it. So definitely go and watch that one if you haven't. Going to be working out on Thursday. Also, I failed to mention I have a conference after school, not a conference, but a faculty meeting after school Tuesday. So that's why I'm not going to be working out Tuesday. Going to work out on Thursday. Friday out to dinner. Oh yeah. And it is the weekend. So that's why we got our shades because we are excited. Wake up and be happy Saturday. I'm going to be making burgers in the air fryer. I'm so loving that freaking air fryer, guys. I will have it linked down below too if you're interested. I posted it in my last cauliflower video, but I love that air fryer. It's like my new obsession and I hear that burgers in it are amazing. So I'm definitely going to film that on Saturday and bring that to you guys. I've got the Cali Tots that Waylon and everybody loves. I also have some hamburger buns from the Great Low Carb Bread Company as well. We're going to use on those. So we've tried the hot dog buns before and we love them. So I'm excited to try the hamburger buns on the burgers. So for Sunday night, instead of the Cali Tots, cauliflower tots, we're going to have jicama fries. I've never made them before either. So I'm going to try to film that too. And I'm going to be making them in the air fryer as well. And you're going to see in a few minutes that jicama is huge. So if you plan on making jicama fries, you don't need as many as I bought because they are humongous. So I'm excited about that because that's like new in the air fryer. And then jicama fries, y'all have been telling me, are bomb. Never give up, guys. Keep on trucking. You got this. Foodie this week is going to be keto French toast. And Waylon wanted me to tell y'all that he put that sticker there just for y'all. That's why it's upside down and looking all crazy. So keto French toast with that cinnamon toast from the Great Low Carb Bread Company is coming to you guys on Friday. I'm so stinking excited about it. If y'all make your own like keto bread, you definitely could use it with this keto French toast recipe as well. Next week, I'm going to bring y'all the air fryer burgers. And then I also wanted to ask y'all, are there any keto food requests that y'all want to see on Foodie Fridays? So what are some things keto that you want to see on Foodie Fridays as far as food wise goes? Like something that maybe you are looking for a really good keto recipe and you want to see it on Foodie Fridays. So definitely let me know. I know a lot of y'all have been requesting the blueberry muffins from the Southern Keto Cookbook. I just feel hesitant sharing those on Foodie because they are from their cookbooks. However, I don't think I mind sharing some of the staples out of there, like the blueberry muffins, and just making sure that y'all know that it's from the cookbook and linking the cookbook down below and that kind of thing. But I'm kind of skeptical on doing that. But y'all let me know, just in general, keto food requests. I'll be interested to know. So that is the meal plan this week, guys. Let's get into the grocery haul. All right, y'all. So I have my Blue Diamond almond milk. That is for Waylon and for Dishes for Keto. We love it. And I got some jicama, finally found jicama, but look how hella huge they are. Like, this thing would knock somebody out. Like, what the actual heck? I didn't need this mini. I didn't know how big they were gonna be, but these things are huge. And I'm gonna be making those jicama fries with the burgers. I think that's gonna be so good. Y'all have told me that jicama fries are amazing. And finally, they have it available. So I'm eager to try it. And I would definitely let y'all know in a vlog or in a grocery haul, I will update y'all. Got a cucumber for salads and snacking. Grape tomatoes are for the hubby. He loves grape tomatoes on his salads. They've been out of the organic. Three of the avocados, and again, they're so good with giving me green ones, and they last over a week, guys, in the fridge. Like, that is the best hack y'all have told me. I was leaving them out and they were spoiling like within 3 days. So definitely put them in the fridge. They last forever. I did get some juicy juice, 100% juice, no sugar added. Kiwi strawberry for Waylon and for Trey. Y'all know even before my keto days, I would always dilute this, like not even half and half. I mean, like this much juice and the rest of it ice and water for the boys. I've just been kind of lazy and we just coming back from my little beach trip to make their keto lemonade. And not only that, I don't think this is bad for them. It's 100% juice. And if I'm diluting it, it's okay. They're not getting the straight up, you know, natural sugars, but it is natural sugar. So it's okay. They're kids. I mention that all the time. Also got them some Homemaker orange juice for breakfast on the weekends. This is something new. This is called Fruit Shoot Sparkling Hydro Fruit Punch flavored water. And it says made for kids, zero sugar, zero calories. The only thing though is this has sucralose in it. Which, if I'm going to link that video down below in this video too, I did it in my last vlog, but Keto Connect did a video on different types of sweeteners and how they affect your blood sugar. And now they're not talking about maybe long-term health-wise, but about their blood sugar with keto. Now this says it's made for kids. I did not pick this up for the kids. Actually, I picked this up for the hubby just to have something in the fridge for him because sometimes he gets bored with just regular water and drinks all of our Powerades and I want him to have some more water per se. So I got this, and sucralose does not spike your blood sugar at all, according to that science experiment that they did over at Keto Connect. So I got this. It was $2 and some change. They also have a raspberry one and another flavor. So we're going to give it a shot and see how they are. I might even give one a try because I drink stuff with sucralose in it all the time, and it hasn't affected me on my keto journey. Also for the boys, I got the Roaring Waters Fruit Punch Wave. I needed a box to send to Trace Therapy. Now, y'all know I usually buy the block cheese because this does have more carbs in it than block cheese does. Y'all see it says less than 1 gram of carb. They have to put that in there because they have the potato starch in here. Let me see. Potato starch and powdered cellulose. They add in this to keep it from sticking together, which is the carb count. Guys, I'm just being a little lazy and I got the shredded Monterey Jack, and that is for quesadillas because I honestly did not see at my Walmart a block of this. So I was like, you know what? Just get the shredded. It is not a big deal, girl. It's all right. So then I got the Mama Mary's gourmet pepperoni for our keto pizzas. It's pretty good. It has zero net carbs, and I would like one with no nitrates and stuff, but they don't carry that at my Walmart anyway. I have to go to Whole Foods for that, and it's out of the way. Got some Nature Ripe blueberries. They don't look the best, I have to say, so I might have to eat on these the next couple of days because some of them are looking pretty sad already. What's up with that, Walmart? But however, these strawberries look delish, and they were $1.92 for this 1 pound thing. So I was happy about that. So that's good to go with my Too Good yogurt or just to have for snacking. I got some sour cream just to have some on backup when making dressing or for taco night. Some of the Fresh Craving salsa restaurant style. This is mainly for Lonnie. I'm not really going to eat this probably because the carb count is 2 carbs and 1 gram of sugar for 2 tablespoons. But as y'all know, he's more lax on this low carb journey. So I got that for him because I know he enjoys it. I got Waylon 3 bananas. He loves his bananas. Some shredded iceberg lettuce for the quesadillas. I got some more bacon. This is our favorite. This is the Hormel Natural Choice Original Uncured Bacon. 100% natural, no nitrates, no hormones, blah, blah, blah. This stuff is so thick cut and good. I'm telling y'all, I cooked that in the oven on 400 for like 15 minutes and it's so good. You could definitely cook a little bit longer to make it more crispy, but this is on rollback for $4 and some change. Highly recommend. Now, I mentioned last week that I couldn't like bite off and chew the price of the Karrikohl butter in the sticks, and I can't for baking. However, I needed some spreadable butter, and I do leave some butter in like a butter dish out, and you know, that doesn't spoil, guys. I know a lot of people are like anti that, but you can spread regular butter like that if you leave it get to room temperature. But I wanted to try this. It was on rollback for $2 and some change just to see how the Karrikohl tastes, and this is a naturally softer pure Irish butter by Kerrygold, 8 ounce little tub. And you know, it's just pasteurized cream and salt, contains milk. So everybody raves about it on keto. It's the best butter to get. It was pretty cheap, so I got that. I needed some mozzarella cheese just in case for my fathead dough for the pizzas. I already have a bunch on hand, but I never want to be without on this keto journey. I would rather have too much than not enough when baking, prepping, whatever. So I like to get a little bit more. I got some mozzarella sticks. I was completely out. I do like these. These are the mozzarella string cheese by Great Value. They have 0 carbs at all, and they're 6 grams of fat for 1 stick, so it's a pretty good fat source on keto if you need something fast, quick, snack on the go. Now, I did not pay the $9.39. It was like $8 and some change, and these are just chicken breast tenders, and I got this for the chicken quesadillas with my homemade keto taco seasoning and also to cook up and prep for salads this week. So I went ahead and got that since they're already tenders and I didn't have to worry about the breast. So I thought that was a pretty good deal for $8 and some change. Yes, I would rather have the organic Perdue, but we try to cut corners sometimes where we can, right? Now, the Green Giant Veggie Tots, these things are bomb. If you're not like super strict keto, guys, and you're just low carb, try these out and put these in your air fryer. They taste like regular tater tots in the air fryer. So good. And try them on your kiddos. If you don't want to eat them on your keto journey, that's okay. But see if you can switch your kiddos to this versus the regular tater tots. Waylon, he can eat this whole bag. No joke. He loves them. Trey will eat them every once in a while too with his sensory. And y'all know that's a big deal. So here's the carb count, guys. So it's 10 net carbs for 6 pieces. Yes, that's a lot. But again, if you are, you know, kind of lax low carb, are not worrying about your carbs as much, not bad, and like I said, really good for the kiddos. So I got this for the boys. They've been out of the Stonyfield for a while, and this is what we used to buy, and this is the Great Value on the go tubes, and this is strawberry and blueberry. It says it's not artificially flavored, added, no artificial sweeteners, no high fructose corn syrup. So I went ahead and got that. That's pretty cheap. It's like $1 something. Good deal. Y'all ask me all the time, so here it is. Here are the pork sausage patties that I eat in the morning with my boiled eggs. They're by Great Value, fully cooked. They're frozen, guys. This is like $6. And what you do is you take one out, you wrap it in a paper towel, put it on a paper plate, micro zap it for a minute, and they are delish. Like the easiest thing on the go ever. You don't have to worry about fuss cleanup. Highly recommend. And as far as the macros on there, boom, 20 grams of fat, guys. So great fat content, 0 carbs. And I mean, as far as the ingredients go, I looked at all pork sausage patties and they've all got some flaw. Like unless you go to Whole Foods and go like Cray, this is going to be, you know, a pretty good bet at Walmart because a lot of them have a really high intake of sugar, in my opinion, by looking at the nutritional facts. Frigo shredded Parmesan cheese for pizzas. Yes, Trey's Gordo's cheese dip is back only because I went on vacay and I didn't have time to go get his cheese from Rouse's. It's an ordeal to go to Rouse's and get that cheese. It's not the easiest thing. So I went ahead and got this. They don't carry this anymore at our little Walmart, and that's where I usually do my online order. I went to the big super center today, which I don't like to do because they make you wait long. They made me wait long today. Not too bad, but they do still carry this cheese dip. So I got this to tide him over until I can get to Rouse's and make make his keto queso, because I would rather him have the keto queso than this. This isn't bad. It's just I'd rather it be like homemade versus the process wherever I can. I know that doesn't make sense when you're going to see some of this stuff, but y'all know I am all about cutting corners when you can. You don't have to go like cold turkey. As long as you make little steps and strides, I think that's winning in my opinion. Also, what's winning is this Crazy Richards 100% peanuts and creamy. And this is just straight up peanuts. You might be thinking, girl, you just bought that last week. I did, but I made all those desserts and we used like a whole thing of it with the two desserts that I used. And the boys had none for their PB&J. So I was like, sorry, boys. Mommy ate all of your peanut butter. Diced pears and 100% juice for Trey. Coffee for Mama, the 100% French vanilla. I love these K-Cups. So good. This is something new that I know Trey is going to like die over, and I'm gonna have to hide them because he'll eat the whole thing in one sitting. These are the Glutino Forever Gluten-Free Vanilla Cream Cookies. This is comparable to like the Oreo cream, you know, the white ones. So I got this because he loves any type of Oreo cookie, and this is gonna be like maybe one or two in his lunchbox for an occasional treat. I try to go gluten-free with Trey as much as possible with his autism. I think it is helping and making a difference. Now, Waylon loves these organic cheddar cheese baked snack crackers, and I feel like we just bought these, but we're out and he loves those things. Trey loves the birthday cake Rice Krispie treats, gluten-free. Now, watch your kiddos, because Trey could eat like a whole box if you let him. So I limit him on these, but they are a gluten-free option, so that is good to put in lunch boxes. Waylon loves these mini muffins. I can't get them off of them, guys. Eventually one day, because they're not good for you at all, but he loves them. He's a growing boy. It's all right. And then I've got the dill gherkins from Great Value. This is the fresh pack. There's one net carb for one big pickle. I mean, look how big they are. And I love me some pickles, especially when we are doing the hamburgers. I love having one on the side. Now, this is the Cento San Marzano certified peeled tomatoes, 28 ounces, guys. You need this for the marinara sauce that I make for the keto pizzas. I have that linked in my keto pizza video, so I will link that up above if you want to see how to make that homemade marinara sauce. This is the lowest carb that I have found on here. So as far as the macros, so it's 3 net carbs for, let's say, half a cup. So that's pretty good. A lot of the other ones are really high in sugar and carbs, so this is a pretty good option. Now, they finally had my G Hughes sugar-free stuff. They've been out of stock, and we haven't had any. Me and the hubby, if you watched me on Instagram, were fighting over the freaking barbecue sauce the other day with the pork chops. Like, literally, we had a little bowl, and I was, like, taking a dip, and he was taking a dip, and I'm like, you're taking too big of a dip. That's how serious it was up in here over the sugar-free barbecue sauce. Like, what is our life on this keto train? But, guys, this stuff is so good. Like, the hubby even says how good it is. It is amazing. So it's 2 net carbs per serving, and a serving is 2 tablespoons. It is amazing. I highly recommend it. I think they have other flavors I haven't tried yet, but this is just the original, and we really like it. We also really enjoy the G Hughes sugar-free ketchup. I know y'all said Heinz makes one as well. I might have to try that one. As far as the macros on this, it's 1 gram, 1 carb for a tablespoon. And that's probably all I use. I don't even know if I use a tablespoon. I don't use a ton of ketchup when dipping. And the hubby likes it. And that's definitely a better sugar-free option than what he was eating. So that's good. Something I rave about is the Taco Bell hot sauce. I know that sounds silly, but this stuff is so good. So there's the macros on it. No carbs at all. No fat. 0 calories. It's just got a little, I was going to say sugar. No, girl. Don't have any sugar in there. It's just got a little bit of salt in there. And it is so, so good to spice things up. I love this stuff, and it's so cheap. Now, yes, I always go a little chip crazy. Our pantry was bare. Like, the hubby watched the boys for me over the weekend. And y'all know how boys are. They eat everything in sight. So everything is gone. So that's why I have so many snacks this trip. So Simply Cheetos, 2 of them to send to school and for home. Simply Organic Doritos for home. Trey is loving him some white cheddar popcorn. The Smart Food Popcorn was not $4.99 at Walmart. It was cheaper than that. And you get 12 bags in there, and it is gluten-free, no artificial stuff, blah, blah, blah. So it's pretty good, and he is loving it for snack at school. I got him some gluten-free, thin and crispy, cantina-style tortilla chips to go with his queso dip this week. These are on rollback for 92 cents. They are gluten-free. I am going to switch him back to the blue ones. He's going to hate me because he will eat the blue ones. Y'all ask all the time, how does he eat the blue ones? He does, just because he's like, okay, that's my only option. And he loves his queso, but he definitely loves these better, of course, don't we all? And then I got them some Sara Lee butter bread for their PB&Js. Oh, so that is everything from Wally World, guys. It was $138, I think, at Walmart with tax. And now moving on to Sam's. So I didn't get many things from Sam's. My kids are obsessed with these Nature's Bakery Fig Bars, 24 twin packs. These do not last long at all. They are no high fructose corn syrup, 0 grams of trans fat, dairy free, whole wheat, non-GMO, all the good stuff. Way better than like a Nutri-Grain bar or a Pop-Tart, guys. This is the way to go. But my boys are obsessed, so I have to limit them on these two because I swear, boys will eat like unlimited quantities of stuff. It's cray. I then finally, yes, guys, we're winning. We finally found the organic free-range eggs. Like, what? So they did have them at Sam's. When I went last time, they were making it look like the tag. It was being discontinued. I don't know. Like, I did the online order to pick up Sam's too. But that's good because y'all told me that the free range is the best. I did my research. Y'all are right. These are organic as well, which I haven't been buying organic, just like the cage free. So I'm glad to switch over to these. And this is 24 eggs, and this was $6.98. So I don't think that's a bad deal for 24 eggs, organic, free range, $6.98. Pretty good deal. Go ahead, Sam's. Go ahead, girl. Then got the Taylor Farms Organic Baby Spring Mix. This is $3 and some change. This is almost $6 at Walmart. So definitely a better deal to get this bad boy at Sam's versus Walmart like I was doing to save you a couple of dollars. Then I got Waylon, the organic applesauce. I love getting the organic applesauce there. That's the Walmart, the Sam's Club brand. And it's $9.98 for 24 pouches. This lasts a pretty good while. And he loves it. It's the little packs. And then, guys, I got the Powerade Zero. This is like $12 for 24 of them. That's a really good deal. It's way more expensive at Walmart. And you get the fruit punch, the mixed berry, and the grape. And a lot of y'all were asking about this last time. This does not have aspartame in it. It has sucralose as well. And like I said, some people that do strict keto do not want any like artificial sweeteners like sucralose or Splenda and things like that. They're all about the erythritol stevia, which I am too, but I don't think sucralose is bad. I do think like maltitol and a couple of them are bad because they act as sugar with your blood sugar, and that is proven with Keto Connect's video. But sucralose is okay. Now, does sucralose have bad side effects later down the road? I don't know. You can Google all you want and get horrified. So, but as far as keto blood sugar, it does nothing. So that's my spiel on that. So that is my grocery haul this week, guys, for $180-something. Hopefully we'll be okay in the snack department for a little bit, but I don't know what these boys. Y'all give this video a thumbs up if you look forward to these keto grocery haul and meal plans for me. Make sure to smash that subscribe button, guys. What are you waiting for? Trying to give y'all motivation everywhere I can for this keto life or health journey. Doesn't have to be keto, but just making a couple little healthy steps along is definitely helpful, guys. You don't have to go gung-ho, like I said. Just do a little step at a time, and that is a step in the right direction. I love you guys so much. Y'all have an amazing Tuesday and an awesome week coming up ahead. And guys, just to give you a heads up, I have an awesome keto video popping to you guys tomorrow morning. Make sure that notification bell is clicked, and I'll see you then. Bye, guys.